Good evening, everybody. Hope you all are doing safe and sound. Thank you so much for joining us in today's session. So we have a lot more people coming in. Let's wait for 5 minutes and then begin the session. This session is currently on standby. Let's wait for 3 more minutes and begin the session at 4:05 p.m. All right, let's begin the session. Once again, a good evening. I am Pranita. I am a product specialist at Keka. Along with me, we have Aarti on the chat. So today's session, as you all know, it's going to be on payroll, how to run payroll for a particular month, right? So but if you have any questions at any point throughout the presentation, you can just drop a line on the chat and we'll try to clear them out. Okay, so without any delay, I'll just start sharing my screen. Please confirm once you're able to view it. Can you please confirm if you're able to view my screen? And I hope I'm audible too. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah. Yes. So in today's session, we would be focusing on how to run payroll for a particular month. So we have simplified the process of payroll as an extremely integral part of the operations, right? So we'll have to at the end of every month. So most employees anticipate either at the end of the month or first day of the month, is my salary credited or not, right? So it's our responsibility to make sure that this process is seamless, correct? Yeah. So in today's session, let's focus on all the 6 steps that are involved in running payroll on Keka. Okay. So to navigate to payroll page, so this would be the home screen, Keka home screen. So we'll have to go to payroll and then run payroll. So prior to this, I had added a few employees so that it's easier for you to understand. And we'll take that as an example and try to finish the session. Okay, so let's try to run payroll for the month of June. Okay, so these are the 6 steps involved in running the payroll. I'll just give a quick overview of every step. The first one says leave, attendance, and daily wages. So as the name suggests, yeah, so in this step, we would be dealing with how many people have applied for a leave in that month. Are there any unpaid leaves? Are there any LOPs? And what is there any action we should perform if somebody has not marked their attendance? All of that can be decided in the first step. And second step, new joinees and exits. As a company, you will have several people joining in a particular month, and also we may also see some exits. All of that can be managed in step 2. Then step 3, that is bonus, salary revisions, and overtime. So in case there are any salary revisions, so we have hikes and everything, right? And one-time bonuses or overtime payments, all of that are managed in this step. Next, reimbursement, ad hoc payment, and deduction. So besides an employee's regular salary, we may have certain salary components that are paid once in a while, you know, just a one-off thing, which is not recurring. So that means, for example, I have my basic HRA and conveyance allowance. So basic salary components that are paid every month to me. But there could be a case where I'm getting a payment just for the single month, or I'm having a deduction for any specific month. So all of that can be managed in step 4. Now, step 5. So step 5 says salary on hold and arrears. So salary on, as it suggests, yeah, if you do not want to process somebody's salary or you want to hold somebody's salary from being paid out in this particular month, that can be sorted here. The fourth is the overrides. So after giving, so we have certain formula, we configure formulas and everything right in the system, and we have certain deductions like PT, ESI contribution, PT deduction, and tax, that is the income TDS deduction and everything. So if you want to manually correct this data for any particular employee and or for a set of employees, that can be done from the override step. So let's go in detail into all these steps. So the first one being leaves, attendance, and daily wages. Yeah, so the first one says leave applied. So leave applied step will show you the list of days in which employees have applied for a leave and what is the status, whether or not it is approved or anything is pending, right? If there is any leave request pending, this is the place where you can also approve that particular leave request. For example, I am able to see one employee, Pranita Suri, and these are all the leave days. They're all unpaid leave and the status here is approved. So in this particular month, this is the leave summary of this particular employee. Okay, next is second step, no attendance. No attendance is a case where no action, there are set of employees for whom there is no, attendance has not been marked for any particular day. I have an employee called test employee and on the 30th of June, there was no attendance. And also no action has been taken. So in that case, if you wish to deduct any particular leave because there was no attendance, you can do from this step. So in this case, I just want to deduct. I have casual leave balance of one, so I can just deduct one casual leave. I hope this was clear. Similarly, not just casual leave. You can cancel, you can also change leave type. If you want this to be an LOP, you can also configure this as an unpaid leave. I hope this was clear. Yeah. So that's about the second step. Now I'll just save and continue. Now, so this step is crucial. So this says LOP summary. LOP summary will give you the entire LOP data of that particular month. And this is the place where you can do any kind of adjustments you want to. I have two employees here, Pranita Suri and test employee with LOP days 22 and 21. So these are already system calculated LOP days. So in any case, you want to make any changes to this step, then all you can do is just, we have a column, right? LOP adjustment. For example, for Pranita Suri, actual LOP days are 22, but I do not wish to deduct any sort of LOP for this month. So I can just override that to zero and then I can add a comment saying no LOP. And in case you want to increase the LOP count, for example, for test employee, the actual LOP days are only 21, but you want the entire month to go as LOP. So you can just adjust it to 30 days. Here we have only two employees, hence we have manually just written it. And if you want to if you have a list of employees, we cannot do it one by one, right? In that case, this operation can be done in bulk as well. So we have an option called import LOP days. If it's just a single employee, you can just click on add employee and type their name in here. Otherwise, you can just import LOP. You have an Excel sheet here. You can download the Excel sheet, give the correct LOP number, and then save and continue. Got it? So that's the, So here we are, LOP summary. Now we have something called LOP reversal. So LOP summary is clear. What LOP we want to deduct in that particular month, we'll put it. Now what is LOP reversal? Say in the month of May, that is, we are currently running June's payroll, right? In the month of May, you have deducted some LOP, say 5 days of LOP for some employee. Now, for some reason, maybe the employee had come back and applied for a different kind of leave, or for whatever reason you may have, you want to reverse that LOP. So instead of, you want to pay it back. Say, instead of, say, 5 days, you only want to deduct 3 days. In that case, you can just add that employee and reverse the LOP days here. So this will be done. Say, if you have 5 LOPs in the previous month, you can, if you adjust it to 4, then you can just reverse whatever days you want, you can reverse it off. Okay, so these are the 4 steps involved. Once these 4 steps are completed, again, this also can be imported in bulk through the Excel sheet. You have to mark as complete. Now, so I think I missed in for bringing this up before beginning the session is, unless and until we finish all these 6 steps, we will not be able to finalize payroll. The finalize payroll button will be grayed out. So unless we finish this, we won't be able to move ahead. So the moment I clicked on save and complete, we got a tick here, right? This means this step is completed. Now let's move to the next, that is new joinees and exits. Yeah, so in this month, I have a new employee called test employee who joined on the 1st of June. On the 1st of June, and the salary details are available. But here, certain details are missing. Bank account is missing, PAN number is missing, right? These documents are missing. So you can choose to process his salary, you can void, or you can hold payout. Or if you have already paid, you can also choose the same. Okay. So for now, I want to process this as salary. So I want to pay it along with the other salaries. But we have also say if you have an employee joining in like the end of the month, say 28th or 29th, if you wish to hold that particular month's salary, then you can also do that as well. Okay. Now, save and continue. Employees in exit process. Say if you have anybody in the exit process in that particular month, then in that they will come up here. People, whoever is in exit process, will come up here. And full and final settlement. Full and final settlement will give us the list of employees whose F&F has to be settled in this month. So currently there are no employees here, so we do not have. But from here you can see if there are any settlements due in this particular month, you will get it here. And the action items also will be visible. Once these three steps are completed, you can mark as complete. I hope this was clear. I'll just quickly look if there are any questions. What is meaning of void means, Rohit, void is not paying that salary at all. Right? Not paying that salary. Okay, what needs to be done after downloading? Yes. Let's go back to that. I think we have a question there, right? So what has to be done after downloading? Okay, say I am here. It's like any other import. So for example, if I want to import a number of days, I'll just download the Excel sheet. And then I have the Excel sheet downloaded. And I'll. Are you able to view the Excel sheet? No, is it okay? Let me reshare my screen. I'll share the Excel sheet as well. I hope you can see it now. Yeah, so here I'll have all the list of employees, and here I can update how many loss of pay days are there. And then I can just go back to the same screen and upload the Excel file. So my data will be saved. I hope that was clear. Perfect. All right, so that's about the first step and second step. So we had already done with two steps. Now, so this is the favorite part, bonus, salary revisions, and overtime. Because who doesn't like some extra payment, right? Yeah, so let's do one thing. Let's try to add a bonus for any employee. So we have an employee called Pranita Suri, right? I'll just go to the employee's finances. And I'll go to pay. Now, I'll try to add a bonus. Okay, I'll just give some yearly bonus. The amount could be 50,000. And I will give the payout date as 1st of June or say 30th of June, and it is pending. I'll just add it. See, now the moment I click on bonus, I have added a bonus that is pending, that is due this month, right? It has automatically populated here. Okay, so in any case, so when you're trying to add salary, right? When you're trying to add salary, you might have already added bonus and respective payout dates of the bonuses. So if there is any bonus due in that particular month, we will automatically get it here. Now it's up to you. Now it's up to you whether you want to pay it. You want to hold the bonus, as you've already seen, void means not pay the bonus. Paid outside KK payroll. Outside KK payroll means not along with the regular salary. Elsewhere, outside already paid. And we have an additional step here called partially pay. So let's see what partially pays. So when I want to say partially pay, so maybe I don't want to pay entire 50,000 now. I want to enter some 50%. So I just want to pay 50% now. And what do I want to do with the rest? I don't want to pay the rest. I'll go with void. If I want to carry forward the rest, I'll just click on carry forward. So that is what partially pay. Pay means entire thing will go. On hold means that will not be paid out in this particular month. Void means it will not be paid at all. So I will not get any bonus. This employee, Pranita Suri, will not get the bonus. Outside KK payroll means not along with the salary. Partially pay, you can choose how much you want to pay. It can either be an amount or it can be a percentage as well. I hope this was clear. Okay. Now, so if it is one employee, yeah. Say if this, we also have an option here. Import bonuses, import bonus with action. It's the same. So here also we have Excel template which can be downloaded and same thing can be uploaded here. I'll just save and continue. Salary revisions. So salary revision, as we are aware, say if the employee's salary is increased or decreased, so that becomes a revision. So all of that will come up here. If in that particular month, if there are any salary revisions, they come up here. And overtime payment. So overtime payment is where if you have an OT policy in place where you have configured saying, if you have assigned an OT policy and payment and everything is added already, then that particular month, if there are any OTs to be paid out, that will be come up here. Again, the same thing can be done through the Excel as well. Same goes with shift allowance. So OT and shift allowance are not mandatory. It varies from company to company. If you have a policy in place and it is assigned to respective employees, system will automatically pick up the data and show us here. Mark is complete. So we've already finished three steps. Now the fourth step. I hope it was clear so far. When salary revision happens, yes. Yes, Devlina, we can do that in bulk. All right. So let's quickly go to the fourth step. That is reimbursement, ad hoc payment, and deduction. So as I told, for the first step here, it says salary component claim. So what comes under salary component claim? See, in your salary structure, you have certain components like reimbursement or reimbursable components. So these two components have to be claimed by the employees. So if any employee has claimed in this particular month such components, they will come up here automatically. Okay? Whatever it's approved or if it's pending, all of that are to be paid out this month, they will come here. Next is expenses. So expenses tab, expenses is where if you have an expense policy where employee can submit bills and claim amount, then they will come up here. Both advance settlements and also cash advance request, everything will come up here. The third step is ad hoc payment. So as I said, ad hoc payment is something. So ad hoc is the very meaning of it is that it is not recurring. So it does not happen every month, right? So it's not like some basic or medical allowance. So every month along with my salary, I'm not getting this payment. But sometimes there is a chance that maybe you have some incentive or a one-time additional payment you want to give any employee or all employees. In that case, we can add something called ad hoc payment. Okay. How, if it's, I'll try to add it for one employee. So I'll try to add. And what is the payment type? I have already created something called webinar allowance. And I'll add the amount as 5,000 rupees. And this is safe. If it's just for one or two employees, it can very well be added. Or if you want to import from previous month. So what this typically means is, currently we are running June, right? Say you have an ad hoc allowance which already happened in the previous, you already paid that in the previous month. And the same data, if you want to import, if you have such data, you can directly import from the previous month. Or we have the classic Excel anyway available for us. You can just download the Excel. You can just tell who is that employee getting, what type of payment are they getting, and how much are they getting. All these details can be filled and directly import in this very page. I hope that was clear. Okay, moving ahead. Now, ad hoc deduction. So ad hoc deduction, so these ad hoc payments and deductions, right? So these are something you want to pay or deduct along with your salary, but just for that single month. I hope I'm making sense. Yeah. So deduction is something, yeah, say if you have some damage in a particular month or any, for any reason you want to, we have seen a lot of COVID deductions happening and all of that. In any case, if you want to do something, same. You can just come, add employee's name here. Similarly, like how we have added the deduction, you can just add the amount and then save and continue. This can be done for one employee or for all employees in bulk. Mark is complete. So that is how. Yeah. So we have completed fourth step. Now the fifth step, salary on hold and arrears. So here we have three steps, salary processing, salary payout and arrears. Salary processing on hold is when you do not want to execute any particular employee salary at all. So if I add an employee, like if you have somebody who has unnoticed left the organization, or for some reason you do not want to process the salary at all, because you're not sure for that particular month whether or not you want to show in your records. In that case, you can just put add any employee and hold the processing altogether. So nothing, they will be PF, ESI, TDS, all of that. They will also be excluded from all of these calculations as well. Okay, so that is what processing on hold means. So entire salary processing will be put on hold. Nothing will happen there. But salary payout on hold. Payout on hold means employee salary will be processed. It's just that in that particular month, they will not get a payment. So we are just holding the payout, but processing will happen. When I say processing will happen, PF, whatever PF is supposed to be contributed, that will be shown. If there is any ESI, and tax calculation, and how much the salary is for that month, all of that calculation will happen. But it's just that payment will not happen. So if you do not want to pay that, then you can just hold employees' salary payout and arrears. So there are multiple occasions where arrears can be populated. Arrears typically means, say, in the month of June, my salary got revised, but the salary revision is effective from the 1st of April. Yes or no? For some delay, for some XYZ reason, in April and May, and my salary did not get revised. But in the month of June, it got revised, but the effective date is April, which means I will get my salary arrears for the month of April and May. So this is one occasion. And say you have put somebody's salary on hold in the previous month and you want to process it as arrears. In that case also, we get certain salary arrears. So if there are any such salary arrears, then they will be populated on this screen. I hope it was clear. Yeah. So salary on hold and arrears. Do we have any questions? Okay, you want me to repeat? Okay, got it. Yeah. So salary on hold and arrears. So I hope salary processing on hold is fine, right? Or do you want me to repeat? It's fine. I'll repeat the entire step. Salary processing on hold is when you are unsure whether so you do not want to process. So what does it mean for when we say we are processing the salary? Employees' contributions will be considered. Employees' gross earnings will be considered for TDS calculation and all the filing, everything. So basically, everything will be considered. But if you do not want any of this to happen for any particular employee in that month, you can stop processing of the salary. Say, for example, some employee randomly stopped coming on the 31st of May, and you are unsure whether or not, they did not come in June. You don't know whether or not they'll come or they'll be a part of your organization or not. But you cannot exit the employee because you do not have a, proper notice or anything, right? For some reason. So in that case, you can put the salary processing, entire processing on completely on hold. So that is what salary processing on hold means. Now, next is salary payout on hold. Payout, as I said, we will process the salary. We'll have all the contributions. Say if it is 1800, it'll be 18. If my PF is 1800, that will be shown. If my TDS is 6000, that will be shown. All of that will be shown. But in that particular month, I don't want to pay that salary. Okay, I will release that payment in my following month or that following. That's up to me. I'll just process the salary, but I will not. I'm choosing not to pay that salary in this particular month. That is what salary payout on hold means. Next is arrears. Arrears are nothing but if there are any past dated salary revisions. Now, April and May is already finalized, so we cannot go back and increase my. Ideally, we should not be doing that. If I received 40,000 in May, I cannot go back and change. No, your salary is revised, your May salary is 60,000. We cannot do that, right? Instead, we will pay that whatever amount was not paid in previous month, we will pay in the current month as arrears. So they are called arrears. So we'll have when somebody's salary is on hold, we may choose to pay it out as arrears. Or when there are past dated salary revisions, arrears will automatically come up in this page. Okay, so that's the end of the fifth step as well. Now the last step, overrides, PT, ESI, TDS, and LWF. Okay, override. Okay, so what does it mean to override something? So as I earlier said, we have already system generated values as per the formulas given or as per the in the structure whatever is given. Depending on that, we already have certain values the system gives us, saying against each and every component we have a value defined for any employee. Now, if you want to make changes, that is when you override something. So for in any month, if you want to override any employee's PT, then all you have to do is just import. So the regular PT system calculated to PT is 200, but now I want to take 300. In that case, you can just add a comment. Adding a comment is mandatory, and you can do it. So it's not necessary that you will have to do overrides from here. These are, as you are, most of you must be already aware that they are also possible from payroll admin operations page as well. So when we are doing it from this page, we are basically localizing it only for this month. So this override is applicable only in the month of June, only in June's payroll. Okay, yeah. And if you want to delete some override, you can just delete it from here. Now, ESI override, same step. So if you want to override somebody's ESI contribution for that month, do it. TDS override. So I'll try to override my TDS. So the regular TDS I have is what, 11,684. I do not want to pay, but that doesn't mean I should not pay. I am liable to that tax and I will have to pay. So be sure if you are overriding any value, you are 110% sure and you have records for it. Yeah, so I have overridden the TDS value to zero. I'll just give a comment, manual override. and then save and continue. Same for LWF. So LWF, if you have any LWF in that particular month, and if you wish to override, yes. So that's the end of the six steps. Now we see all the ticks, right? Which means we completed the six steps. But does this mean that we have finalized? Yeah. So one important step is, we may complete all the six steps, but before we finalize, we always have the option to come and modify anything here. Say, I have no attendance. I have LOP summary here. So now I want to say no by 0 days. Now I want to deduct 2 days of LOP. Yeah. So before finalizing payroll, we always have the option to make changes to any of the six steps. Now, if I made any changes in the salary or if I added any bonus, I want the changes to reflect here, right? Now we have a very, very important step that is called preview run payroll. So what preview run payroll does is that it will save any changes made in the financial information. Okay, any information related to the employee's finances in that particular month, for it to reflect and be saved, we will always have to click on preview run payroll. Be it any salary revisions or adding a one-time payment or deduction or overriding any employees, any salary component. For all of these changes to reflect, we will have to click on preview run payroll. And once you click on preview run payroll, right, you will have a pay register also that is generated. Okay, so this pay register, okay, I'll show you. So once I clicked on preview run payroll, right, if I see here, I have this certain values, okay, that says this is my total payroll cost for the month, and this is what is going to the employee, and these are the total deductions. What are these deductions? I have added a deduction, if you remember. I added something called webinar reduction, right, over 1,000 rupees. Yeah, so I added this deduction has come up, and total contribution. So contributions will include what? PF, ESI, and all of that will come up here. So I only have two employees here for this month. So they have come up here. Now I'll do a preview run. Okay. So this is it. So after the six steps, what do we generally do? We click on finalize payroll. Okay, I did a preview run. I checked everything is intact according to me. I'll just finalize payroll and see what will happen. I got some error here. So it says payroll processing aborted. Isn't this an error? So basically, system is telling me I have missed out on something and I have to go back and check it, right? So where do we check it? So in case when you're trying to finalize payroll, you're getting this error, always go to review all employees. And then once you click on review all employees, you can see net salary review and something called unprocessed salaries. Unprocessed salaries will give us the list of employees whose salary is not being processed because of some error. If you see, I have some test employee here for the month of June, and the status is not executed. It is error. And the error message is because of some warnings. Now, what are these warnings? Add bank details, add PAN details. If you remember, when I tried to go to new joinees and exits, it actually told me that these documents are missing. You know, it showed a warning saying the documents are missing, but I did not pay attention to it. So because of which now my salary, I'm unable to finalize my salary. Now, how do I correct it? It's pretty simple. I have to go to that employee's profile. And then basically I'll just go to the employee's profile here, test employee, right? And add the bank account details. Where do I add bank account details? I'll go to finances. Just salary information is added, nothing else. Everything is pending for this employee because it's a new joinee, right? So just click on PAN card. And if PAN details are not available, just check this. Yeah, if just add any bank details. Okay, see, now I have added those details. Okay, so what do we do after adding those details? We will have to come and click on preview run payroll because we want the changes to be reflected. So I'll come, I'll do a preview run payroll. I'll review all employees before finalizing. And now I see both of them are falling here. Both of them are under net salary reviews. Yeah, in this step, we also have this additional. I'll just click on view details. So there's some change in my salary, 23% change in my salary. I want to know why. See, we have added an LOP of 2 days, right? So because of LOP, I'm getting less pay this month. So you can also verify that. And for this employee, it is processed for the first time. And I don't have anybody in unprocessed salaries. I can just finalize payroll. Yeah. So this is how we complete all the 6 steps and finalize payroll. But is this it? Is there something else we should be doing after finalizing payroll? Of course. First is tell the accounts people that, you know, we have successfully finalized payroll for the month. And we should generate bank statements, right? So let's see how to, what are the post, so these are called post payroll activities. That is after you finalize payroll, what is it that you should be doing? Then, so this is how the page will look like once the payroll is finalized. And after that, just click on manage payments. So in manage payments, you see, we have something called, if you see salaries to be batched. How do you want to pay pending salaries to the employees? Say you have a lot of employees and maybe you want to create, you do not want to pay all of it at once. We also have an option to create batches where you can group employees in particular batches and then release the payment. Okay, so if you don't have that, you can pay all of them at once. Or if you want to pay in batches, I'll just create a payment batch. I'll just call it batch one. And I'll select the, so these are my company bank account details. And I'll just click on. Okay, now who do I want to batch? I'll just select. Then I'll create a batch. Got it. So this is how I have created a batch with just one employee because I've had only one. I just created for this one employee. Okay. Now, how do we download? So this is how it looks once the batch is created. Then from here, you can either edit it or you can delete the batch if you want to, you know, go back and reiterate everything and then download. So you can download bank-wise statement or entire consolidated bank statement or this employee is in Andhra Bank. So you can just download it in an Excel or a PDF and you can share it across with your team members. Okay, so that's about, so this is what we should do at the back end. But employee doesn't want this now. What does employee want? Employee wants, all the employee wants is to see where is my pay slip, right? First is where is my salary? For that, they'll keep looking at their SMS if the salary is credited or not. Next is, where can I download? Where can I see my payslip? Where can I download my payslip? Right? For that, just click on view manage payslip. So manage payslip, in manage payslip, they'll get all the list of employees. You can just select those employees. And then any employee you can just select. And you can release the payslip. So, or you can hold back. Release the payslip. What release the payslip typically does is that, once I release the payslip as an employee, if I go to my finances, pay and payslips, right, I will be able to see. I can see and download. So you can also check the status as well. So for this employee, I'll just release the payslip. See, payslip is released, email sent. So we also have an option to hold back payslip is not showing, not releasing the pay. It's the opposite of what releasing the payslip is. Okay, so see now the payslip status, release payslip status became no, and send payslip by email. So when you select send payslip by email, right, they will receive an email from the system saying with an attachment. They'll receive an email with an attachment. So that is what it is. So these are post payroll activities. Now if you want to download your salary sheet for that month, we have already seen the pay register. Yeah, so here I'm getting some warning. It says actual tax payable is so-and-so, but deducting zero as per TDS override. So such details are also captured. So you can just download the Excel and save it for your record. So this is it, everybody. So this is how, so these are the steps involved in running the payroll, and these are the post-payroll activities. Let's check if there are any questions. An employee's last working days in June, the company policy within 45 days of exit. Yeah. That means that payment has to be done on or before 30th of July. Yes. Yes. Correct, Anup. That's up to you. That's totally up to you. So you can choose to do that. So I'll tell you how it works. So if the employee's last working day is in June, so his July salary would not be there, right? So you can hold, while you're settling the F&F, right? You can choose to pay out in the month of July itself. So there June wouldn't come at all. Correct. So when you're trying to process the F&F, you will have to select July month. No. So it will not show as 30th because it was actually paid along with July's payroll, right? If you are processing it outside of KECA, then you can very well show it as the 30th. But if you are finalizing in this particular, in any month along with the payroll, that will only, it will come up then only. But however, this doesn't mean the last date and everything will change. It's just that it is, if it is being processed through the payroll, it will be processed in the month it is selected while processing F&F. Investment declarations. Sure, Vasish. So at the moment, I'm afraid we would not be able to cover it because that's a different topic altogether. We can very well have a session on that if most people are interested in it. We can very well have a session where we can understand how to make declarations or what are the admin actions we have and all of that. Absolutely. Noted, noted, everybody. So most votes for investment declaration, is it? Okay, I think we can have a session on tax and settings and Noted. We'll definitely try to have a session on that. Yeah. So an update for everybody. So these sessions would be uploaded on YouTube. So this recorded session will be made available on YouTube. So we request you to subscribe to the channel so that you get a notification whenever there's a new upload there. Yes, this recording will be made available on YouTube. Yes. Yeah, we'll share the link. We'll share the link. Yes, thank you, Aarti. Yeah, so Aarti has shared the link in the chat. So you can just subscribe to that. थैंक यू सो मच। Sure. I think that brings us to the end of the session today. Yeah, so once again, we have shared the link here. Please subscribe to that channel so that you're notified whenever there's a new upload here. And please, please stay safe. And see you all in the next session. Thank you again.